Back here in Connecticut, a concert violinist and UConn professor who was born in Ukraine is sharing her story. This comes as voices are growing louder across Connecticut showing support for Ukraine. Rallies were held today from Hartford to New Haven calling for action and assistance. Fox 61's Alicia Machado joins us live in the studio tonight with the New Haven violinist's message after Russia's invasion of Ukraine. Alicia?
Well, Carmen, this is a scary time for Solomia Ivahiv and her family in the Ukraine with so much uncertainty after the invasion. She tells me her brother's wife and two young children were in line for 2 days to cross the border to safety, and her brother stayed behind.
My whole family is there. So, yes, it's very scary, very nerve-wracking. My grandma just turned 85. She survived World War II. It's heartbreaking to see that she has to go through another war in her lifetime.
Concert violinist and head of strings at the University of Connecticut, Solomia Ivahiv's thoughts are with her family and friends in Ukraine after Russia's invasion of the country.
My family, they are helping refugees from eastern Ukraine that come to western Ukraine, where I'm from, and they help them with food and clothing and just setting up camps for them.
Ivahiv was born in Ukraine and came to the U.S. to study. Her culture and homeland, an inspiration for her music. Last week, she released a new album recorded with the National Symphony of Ukraine in Kiev.
Now it's very difficult for me to think that not only my colleagues in the National Symphony are in danger, but also there is a war going on in the place where we performed and where we record, and we don't know what's going to happen tomorrow.
Ivahiv says the country needs help from the rest of the world, including the imposition of a no-fly zone over Ukraine. Around the state, voices are growing louder with support for Ukraine. Stand with Ukraine rallies were held in New Haven and Hartford Sunday, including this one at St. Michael Ukrainian Catholic Church in New Haven. State leaders fired up about the situation, including Governor Lamont.
You have a president who is an inspiration in Ukraine and an inspiration around the world, standing up and confronting evil every day. And we're standing there right with them. We're standing up for freedom and we're standing up for human rights. That's what this battle is all about. And Ukraine, you are not alone.
Senator Richard Blumenthal calling for stronger sanctions and a boycott of Russian goods. At the rally, Blumenthal referencing President Vladimir Putin putting nuclear forces on high alert Sunday.
Another scare tactic, another attempt to intimidate the world. But the world is not buying it. And the world should stop buying Russian goods, Russian services, boycott Russia.
As we look around the nation, so far leaders in Utah, New Hampshire, and Ohio have called on liquor stores to stop selling Russian-made products. Carmen?